action-packed week of sports it's been, and I have Ayaz Naiman to take us through all the action. Let's get to the big disappointment of the weekend, Ayaz. India versus Sri Lanka. India lost to Sri Lanka by 63 runs, and they were unable to chase down a target of 176. What's gone wrong for India?
Like, well, actually, it was a sensational collapse. We've seen very few such collapses.
Yeah.
We saw one recently when Australia collapsed for 60 against England, and before that 136. But that was in the first innings. This was a second innings collapse. For 3 days, it seemed that India had this match, you know, by the stranglehold. And then the fourth morning just completely went to pieces.
Yeah.
Now, it's not that this is the first time it's happened. I know of at least two matches, one of which features India, where we won. Headingley, 1981, Ian Botham's match. Turned around the game completely. Australia asking England to follow on and then losing the match. And then, of course, India beating Australia again. In Kolkata in 2001, VVS Lakshman making 281. So, look, much as we can be critical, as we should, of the Indian team's, you know, what I thought was a really weak-hearted batting performance in the second innings, we must also give credit where it's due. Sri Lanka hung on for dear life for 3 days, you know, and the tenacity is what helped them get through. They had a great innings from Dinesh Chandimal, who's a young player.
The century.
And then, of course, Rangana Herath with all his experience.
7 wickets.
I mean, so, it's one of the great turnaround tests. Where the sport is concerned, I thoroughly enjoyed the match. I think it was a great contest from the cricketing point of view. But I think now India is on the back foot. So, a test match starts
this week. Yeah.
Sangakkara's last match. They'll be all pumped up. While India are really looking at, you know, how to save their skins now.
Yeah.
In a sense, both Virat Kohli and Ravi Shastri and the rest of the team, they have their tail between their legs.
Yeah.
They need to come out, you know, with a strong performance for their tail to wag again.
So, what do you think they need to change? That, like, I know Stuart Binney is being recalled to the team and they're mixing and like, what combination should we go with? Because on a pitch where 31 wickets out of the 40 fell to spin, Harbhajan Singh took just one for 90.
You're right. I think, you know.
So, what's the combination that India should go for?
That's the dukhtinas, as you the painful part. Two aspects, you know, kind of very disappointing or dismaying from the Indian point of view. One was the form of Rohit Sharma. He fell in both the innings. In the first innings to a pace bowler, in the second to a spinner. And Harbhajan Singh on a turning track, 17 overs, 73 runs, not getting a wicket. He's got 400 plus test wickets, so it's not that he doesn't know.
And Ashwin did quite well.
But Ashwin has been able to raise his game, sensing competition from Harbhajan or the return of Harbhajan. He's upped his game. He did everything to win the match for India. And I think somewhere that one wicket or two wickets which India needed, when the match was not in the balance but completely in their favour, didn't come their way. And Harbhajan, I think might get it in the neck for the second test.
Okay.
I think that the Colombo pitch also does help the seam bowlers a bit.
So what changes are you suggesting that India should make?
I think that they will probably drop Harbhajan and go in with an extra seamer.
Okay.
Whether it's Binney or whether it's Bhuvneshwar Kumar, we'll have to wait and see what the combo is.
Yeah.
And there'll be serious pressure on them to retain Rohit Sharma. Though I feel they might give him one more chance.
Okay.
Before they get somebody like a Cheteshwar Pujara in. But you never know if they're, you know, if they've got really kind of bamboozled by the defeat, they might go in for some sharp changes.
Yeah, so that's that. We'll have to just watch and see. Let's see. Hopefully, India can make a comeback. So, while India lost to Sri Lanka on Independence Day, we did have some good news on that day where Saina Nehwal winning the silver medal at the World Championships. She's the first Indian to do so. And even though she lost to the defending champion, Caroline Marin, in straight games, this has been a very good performance from her.
Well, a silver medal at the World Championship is very
historic.
Big. And along the way, she beat a Chinese.
Wang, who
was
9-2, she had a losing record against
her.
Monkey off her back completely.
Completely.
She's conquered the Chinese now.
I think Saina has been making progress. You know, I mean, she's been in the top 4 or 5 for the last 3-4 years.
Yeah.
So,
and she again becomes number one.
She becomes number one.
Because she's reached the finals.
Correct. So I think that, you know, her status or her stature in the game is massive. The World Championship has eluded her, but I don't think that there's any disappointment or, you know, despair.
I think just on the day, she
accepted Marin was a cut above her. The way she fought back,
it's
in the
interesting
set,
how this
5-12
a,
down
yeah,
to come
I
and
know.
Win. You have to give credit where it's due.
Yeah, totally.
I think Saina should be very happy with her performance. She's probably got about a year and a half, 2 years to become or you know fulfill all her aspirations. I think post the Olympics, maybe yeah. another year.
Mm-hmm.
But what this she's is, done so yeah, far is phenomenal.
Yeah, and it's become a very good rivalry, right? Marin versus Sangha.
It has.
All India,
remember,
India.
If you remember, even in the India Indian all, Badminton yeah. League, yeah. which was played in 2013, they had a couple of yeah. good matches.
The All England match was amazing.
The All England
yeah.
match was amazing. So. You know, these are not traditional
yeah,
centers
Chinese,
for
yeah.
for excellence. This is not China, Malaysia, yeah. Singapore, Korea.
Yeah.
This is
Spanish and an Indian.
Spain and
yeah.
India.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's great for the sport
yeah.
that two non-conventional centers, mm-hmm. so to speak, are dominating the sport, at least in the women's section.
Yeah. And Saina Nehwal, she wasn't the only Indian who did really well over the weekend. We had good news in golf. Anirban Lahiri. Top five finish. Never again. It's a historic moment because it's the first.
It's
Indian.
Massive.
Yeah.
To finish in the top five. You know, I mean, obviously nobody has done it earlier, but it also tells you where sport in India is headed,
yeah.
and of course where Lahiri
different
can
sport,
go.
Yeah, yeah.
Different sports. I'm not, you know, cricket. We all know football mm-hmm. is also big. Hockey has been our traditional sport, but these are not usually followed
yeah.
sport or practice sports.
Mm-hmm.
So Anirban Lahiri at this young age. Doing so well
yeah.
is extremely encouraging, and of course,
and he's back in the top 50 because of this. Yeah.
He's back in the top 50. You know, I don't know from here what it takes to make that quantum leap.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whether it's a different kind of a coaching regimen that he needs,
yeah.
or somebody else as a mentor and, or as an advisor, or he just needs to be playing more competitions
yeah.
and you know whatever it takes, but
more exposure,
more experience, more exposure.
Yeah.
Because golf is not like you finish at 28, 30.
Yeah.
You can go on playing and you can excel even later.
Yeah.
So, I think we've got a terrific golfer in Anirban.
And the Archery World Cup was also on where Abhishek Verma, he won an individual gold for India
yeah.
in the men's compound event. And India won a silver in the mixed
so
event.
What
too,
I
so.
Take away from this
yeah.
is in archery.
Yeah.
I mean, it has been our strong point. It's been our forte. But we've been disappointing at
we've not
the
living up to the hype, right?
So the run-in form leading
mm-hmm.
into Rio,
mm-hmm.
which is still about a year away or 11 months away, is looking very impressive.
Yeah.
Looking good. We've
mm-hmm.
had Deepika Kumari doing well earlier.
She won the silver again.
She won the silver again. And therefore, I think, you know, I mean,
good
the
boost.
Archers themselves,
yeah.
the coaches must settle and say, maybe we need two or three medals
yeah.
at the Olympics. That's the way to go. You know, I mean, ultimately, everything climaxes in the Olympics.
Yes.
So that's what they should be heading for.
Yeah. So as we're looking towards, like, you know, less than a year left for the Olympics.
Absolutely.
All these small events just hopefully building
and
it
the,
up
and
for
the
India.
Problems of 2012
mm-hmm.
don't repeat themselves because we had done extremely well till
yeah.
the London Olympics
yeah.
and then we faltered.
Yeah.
So that should not be the case.
Yeah. So hopefully India players have learned from last year and hopefully they can do much better this time around.
Yep.
And Ayaz, as usual, let's just come back to the traditional weekend sports, football.
Don't remind me of what happened to Chelsea.
That's all I've been waiting for.
Yeah.
I have to get your views in on this.
Yeah.
Chelsea versus City. City thrashed them 3-0. And
yeah.
it was...
Chelsea's in trouble.
Yeah, it wasn't just the on-field events that got all the headlines.
Yeah.
Mourinho's comments, his attempts to try and maybe divert attention.
And the medical staff.
The
what
medical
are, what
staff.
Are they up to?
Yeah. That was very astonishing. What do you make of the Chelsea
It compelled
performance?
Me to go in for another bout in my yoga camp which I was attending. 3 hours strenuous session because, you know, it
quite a shocking loss.
It's quite a shocking loss and for a champion team.
Yeah.
Lots of experts, and I'm going to take your opinion, that feel that they might not even finish in the top four.
Okay.
Do you
yeah.
see them
no,
heading
I
there?
Think, I think what's gone wrong is that they didn't really buy anyone to reinforce the team over the summer. Except,
which you mentioned last time.
Yeah, except Falcao, which
yeah.
is not really going to work. And also at this point, they just seem to lack discipline and creativity. It's astonishing to see that from a Mourinho side.
Yeah.
But it's Mourinho. I'm pretty sure that there's still 15 days of the transfer window left. I'm sure he's knocking at the owner's door and saying, you know, we need to invest and we need to get one player.
So there's
in
something
least.
Brewing as
yeah.
I understand it. I mean, you know, these things are very volatile as we know from between
yeah.
owners and coaches and
yeah.
players, the relationship. Can be
I definitely won't count them out, but like
yeah, you won't. I mean,
they have a good
you can't,
team.
You can't count
they
them out. Certainly.
They still have the same team that won them the Premier League last season.
Absolutely.
So I think it's just been two games, but they should bounce back soon.
Yeah, but it's a new season and they haven't started
yeah.
well.
But Arsenal managed to turn things around and they've established 1-1, 2-1.
Yeah.
United continued their winning form. So
which team has impressed you the most from the
looking at
leading
yeah
sides?
So City's leading table, 2-3-0 wins.
Yeah,
amazing. You know, they
and one against Chelsea.
Yeah. And if Aguero is in form, there's no stopping him. He is the goal machine of the Premier League.
Yeah.
Arsenal, if they manage to get another striker in, they will be very lethal.
And what about the manager? What about Van Gaal? What's happening to him?
Van Gaal, I think he is quite a dynamic personality too, right? Like he is one of those forces to be reckoned with, you know. And he says something like, he's completely axed De Gea, you know, he's not making him play. And there's so much, you know, controversy with every comment that any of these managers make, you know. They get into fights and spats, but it's all part of the game, you know. You have to get under the skin of the other manager. And speaking of managers, I think Claude Ranieri, who's managed to turn around his team so well, he's a young manager and he's doing really well. Leicester City again won and they're second right now. So I think that's brilliant, you know. There are a couple of new...
So amongst the giants...
New breed of managers coming up that, you know, I think are ready to challenge. At least the big big names that have firmly established their position.
So from the big names, Wenger and Mourinho seem to be down.
Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit.
Pellegrini.
Van Gaal is...
Van Gaal still has to figure out a lot of things. But Pellegrini, definitely he's had a brilliant weekend. So I'm sure he's happy with that. So from football to a little bit of tennis.
Yes.
Yeah. Murray, he's finally overcome Djokovic in 3 sets on hard court.
I saw a picture on Twitter.
Yeah.
You know, Djokovic, I think more in remorse, you know, kind of breaking loose or breaking free into a big shout. But I think a big psychological barrier for Murray to cross.
Yeah.
You know,
he's not won over Djokovic in almost 2 years.
Almost 2 years.
8 match streak that he's broken.
Yeah.
And he did that in the 3rd set, which is like Djokovic's stranglehold. You know, you can't beat Djokovic
in
the 3rd set.
Yeah, when he takes the match into the decider, then it's very difficult to beat Djokovic. So I think it's a big psychological hump that Murray
and
has crossed.
And now he's world number 2 again.
He's leapfrogged
Federer going into the US Open.
Yeah.
So that's...
I think Federer, we should keep out of all such calculations. He's Roger.
Yeah.
He's
so
Federer.
He'll be back in Cincinnati this week. You know, that's the next event that's coming up. But Marin Djokovic was, you know, you expected him to reach the final. In the women's side, when we're speaking of Swiss players, 18-year-old Belinda Bencic, she won the title. And what a run she's had. In round 1, she defeated Bouchard. Round 2, she defeated Wozniacki. Round 3, Lissiki. Then she defeated Ivanovic, Serena Williams in the semi-final, and Halep in the final. And all 6 of them are Grand Slam finalists. 18-year-old from Switzerland, she's managed to have the run of her life to win this title.
So now the challenge for her, I mean, she's obviously a star in the making.
Yeah, she is.
But really, she has to now show that it's not a, you know, flash in the pan.
Yeah, and so she's coached by Martina Hingis's mother. So that's obviously like a good person to have in your camp. And last year, she made a splash at the US Open when she reached the quarterfinals when she was just 17.
Yeah.
So this year, where she's been able to repeat those results is, I think, very impressive and she's one to watch out for.
Yeah, and if she's doing it at 17 and 18, so she's not, you know, a meteor.
Defeating Serena Williams.
Yeah.
But second loss of the season and she's pulled
fantastic.
It
off.
Fantastic. What a brilliant weekend we've had.
Yes,
and
but for the cricket.
But for the cricket. But hopefully, India can bounce back in the coming week against Sri Lanka.
There's a match starting on the 20th. And
as I know, you'll be
I'll be in Colombo. Yes.
So, we'll get all your views from Colombo next week.
I hope it's, you know, good news.
Yeah. And so, as next week from Colombo, please join us again next week on Monday on the Sportscast. Thank you.